99.9.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Small Time Show. Did you miss us? We missed you. Hey, did you know that at 6,684 feet, Mount Mitchell in Yancey County is the highest mountain east of the Mississippi? Fun fact. Anyway, here's Dead Senate. The kid next door stole my cigarettes. We'll be back after this.
One shot squad. Dead Senate.
He's on my front porch, and he's creeping. He's got one and one hand only objective. The cat next door stole my cigarette. The cat next door stole my cigarette. The cat next door stole my cigarette.
The cat next door stole my cigarette.
He's on my front porch. He's got one and one and only objective. The cat next door stole my shit. The cat next door stole my shit. The cat next door stole my cigarette.
The cat next door stole my.
Awake yet? All right, welcome back again. It's the Small Time Show. We're gonna dive into the boring bits before we go any further into all the other really cool stuff we've got for you today. You guys know the song and dance here. It's the, you know, it's your traffic, it's your weather, and we've actually got a local story we've picked out from this past week. Came across our feed recently. Thought it'd be cool to share on the show. But let's get into it. Traffic, as always, fucking boring. Weather. According to Fox 8, we're rolling with a high of 71 degrees today, a 90% chance of precipitation, so it is wet out there. We're going to drop down to 52 this evening, coming back up to 66 tomorrow for your Friday, only a 20% chance of precipitation, so rolling into your weekend. You're looking pretty good with a 72 for the high on Saturday with clear skies. Mostly cloudy on Sunday with a high of 80 degrees, and we're looking like we're going to be rolling into the 80s most of next week. Now, let's get into this story that I wanted to bring to you guys. It comes out of Belmont, of a drive-in theater. Oh yeah, dude. Like, I've been looking for one of those for a while now. Glad to know there's one in Belmont. So I'm just going to read this verbatim because I screenshot the stuff from the news site here. So, Belmont, NC, Queen City News. The owners of the Belmont Drive-In Theater have kicked off the first full season of film for the first time since the theater closed in 2014. The Pentecost family's history dates back to when their parents and grandparents, Bill and Peggy Lawing, worked at and eventually bought their theater in the 1980s. The kids had to close the theater down in 2014 due to the rise in cost of operations and the industry-changing addition of digital projectors. In 2023, however, 9 years after its closure, the Pentecost family reopened the drive-in for a soft opener, which lasted for 3 months. It was a way to get our feet wet, explained Casey Pentecost. She runs the operation along with the rest of her family and said the 3 months was a validation they needed to make major movements to fully restore this family heirloom. During the winter's off-season, the family made significant changes to the theater, which included changing out panels on the big screen and completely restoring the marquee to its original signage from the 80s. The one thing that was not touched, though, was the $25 per car ticket price charge. That, honestly, I don't think that's that bad in today's economy. I think that's pretty average, considering, like, you know, you go to a movie theater and the prices you see there for just snacks, I mean, it's ridiculous. Coming back to the story, Friday evening, the family welcomed more than 100 families to the showing of a seven-month-long stretch of movie-viewing weather, with surprises thrown in all along the way. To keep track of movies being shown, there's a link right here. I'm going to share it on screen as soon as I can track this back and figure all that out. But yeah, so a drive-in theater out of Belmont has reopened, and I kind of want to take a trip to Belmont. Let me look this up real quick. Oh, it's like an hour and a half. I'd do that drive for a drive-in theater. You know? Like, sure, I don't get to get out of the car, but it's like this retro experience. It seems super cool, you know? I would do an hour and a half drive to go to the Belmont Drive-In Theater. Anyway, let's get into you guys' first music block. So today being a rainy Thursday like it is, I think I'm going to start you guys out with the vibes. So first up, we've got a band name that's all one word, with a song name that's also all one word. It's Car Crash Pool Party. You know I'm bad with names. This is a groovy track. Like, the bass work is immaculate. It's pristine. Not enough adjectives. The guitar is ethereal in the background, adding this really cool texture to the entirety of the song. It's really awesome. And then the drums in the back just kind of command you to dance. All in all, really cool track. You'll see what I'm talking about. Second in line, Cuzco. Cuzco's music. Music for Cuzco. Yes, there is another track in their discography named Pacha. It's on their Spotify. It's beautiful. But it's not the track we have for you today. Today we have Cuzco, Alligator Monday. This is an instrumental math rock track. It flows super well. After Car Crash Pool Party, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's almost trancing. You can get lost in this track. Like, in the various works of instruments in this song. It's wild. So yeah, Cuzco, Alligator Monday, instrumental math rock. Get entranced, I guess. So next up, we've got Marbleberry Seeds, Protest Song 3000. This one's an interesting jam. It's a very unique one out of the four that we've picked for today. Listen to the lyrics. The artist gets pretty heated in this one, and we'd love to see that kind of passion that, you know, when musicians throw it into their work. Marbleberry Seeds, Protest Song 3000. Like, I don't know, it's got this tone to it. I really like it.
You know what you got, Jay? You got moxie.
Blank State wrapping up the vibes block with Say It Back, and this is probably my personal favorite song of theirs out of their entire discography. It stays stuck in my head. Like, I'll catch myself singing it all the time. I'll just be like, and you can make it right again. You see what I'm saying? Like, all the time. It's so catchy. So yeah, Blank State will wrap up the round with Say It Back, and we'll catch you guys after that. It's 99.9.
You have to have the vibes for your vibe check.
Thank you. on the nonsense train. I had a gold membership in the NRA. Imagine a styrofoam container. It's worth undeniable. Common, inexpensive. The structure is reliable. It can't be grown by anyone. It blooms twice a year. In fact, there's a nursery full of them. Not two blocks from here. In America, the free of the land and the brave. So behave or be sent to one of our many crowded prisons. Congressmen call themselves patriots for spying on their citizens. Crack it in your backyard. That's just the time we live in. With political balls of yarn, styrofoam farms, all the propaganda sold out. It lost its charm, but the disclaimer told me the country came to no harm. So sold to our alma mater.
me down easy, cause you can't keep acting like you need me. And when it comes, would you let me down easy?
That was a bit of a ride, huh? Welcome back to the Small Time Show, and not to say we told you so, but we told you so. Before we go any further, to kind of contextualize what we're about to talk about coming up here, we're going to give a little bit of a weekend recap for our venue visit this past weekend to the Den. It's story time.
I'm telling a story!
You know, if nothing else, we have pristine audio clips. Anyway, getting into this story, it's all covered in our like special event coverage on our Instagram at 999TheZ. If you're not following us yet, we're kind of awesome, so you should. Anyway, so we're going to talk a little bit about the venue first. This was our first time at the Den. We were a little sketched out at first, honestly. The GPS kept trying to take us to the Ramada. A little bit about that. If you've ever been in that area of Ogburn, if you've ever been to the Den, you know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. Like, it's a little sketchy over there. But thankfully, Tony, our savior of the story here, the guy that runs the place, has a sign put up in the window letting people know where to look. From there, we're all good. Officially met Tony a little later in the evening. Dude, I'm going to use gender-neutral pronouns because I never asked. That's my bad. But the dude knows their stuff, right? Like, it's their place, and you can tell it, they know it like it's their place, you know? On top of that, super cool person. Dude was super chill the whole evening. You can tell they love what they do, and they do it for the right reasons. It's awesome. We love to see it. We look forward to keeping in contact with Tony and the Den in the future. And what I mean by that phrase, it's their place, and you can tell they know it like it's their place, is that, like, and also what I mean when I say, like, synonymously that Tony is kind of the savior of the whole story here, is that Tony was running everything all night. All night. It was crazy. Everything from sound to lights, like, all of the transitions, running the bar, which, you know, to be fair, it's not a big bar, and it's a refrigerator with drinks in it, essentially. But it's still a bar area that people come up to, and it was a pretty crowded night, so, like, you know what the fuck I'm saying, dude? Like, Tony gets a goat award for venue owners. Anyway, moving into our next spot, we're going to talk about Folk Knot. Right from the jump, it's awesome. Right when walking into the venue, it's showtime, things are just getting going, Folk Knot's up first. And I don't feel like I did this part walking into their set enough justice in the post as I could have. I just don't think I could think of the words at the time. But I'll go ahead and disclose this now. When I walked into that venue, when I walked into the Den that evening, this transportation that I mentioned in the second paragraph is almost immediate. Like, yeah, I get hit with this, with the soothing vocals and the guitar and the accordion and the keys on the way in, you know? And I'm getting hit with that and I'm hearing the key changes, but, like, as soon as I give Tony the money for the ticket and get myself in, like, into the show and stuff, as soon as I do that, this violin just graces over the staff, and it's crazy. Like, immediately I was like, okay, I'm here, I'm in it. I'm in it now. 10 toes down, we in it. So yeah, I don't feel like I did Folk Knot enough justice in this part. I mean, I barely found the words just now, but crazy good of a band to just be walking into. And they were only 4 members wide that evening. They announced a new album coming out in May, and I think that was their big news for the evening. I was surprised to learn that they were 4 members wide that evening, but there are actually a number more of them. I never got around to asking
how many, or like, I don't think anybody did. If they did, I don't remember it. But yeah, that's Folk Knot. Crazy good. Crazy good band. Check them out on Spotify. So it takes a moment switching things around, but when it all gets going again, it's Blank State up next. Yeah, we're going to talk about Blank State. Before I get into talking about Blank State, though, like, before I get into the set, I want to say that, like, you know, the guys from Blank State played with the guys from Nervous Surface, like, through both of those band sets, and there was this one amplifier on stage that, if I ever get the chance to have them on the show and talk to them, like, I'm gonna bring it up. But they went, I went this whole show, like, these whole two sets before the Iliad set, and did not realize that this amplifier had the Blank State logo instead of where the manufacturer's logo should be. And it was just like, it was so cool. It blended, well, I'm not gonna say blended into the other equipment, because you can like kind of see it in the post in the Blank State part of it. You can kind of see it a little bit, but it kind of blends in. But dude, I did not notice that was there. Like, the specifically, I noticed the amplifier, but not the logo, and that was just the coolest thing, getting that put there. I don't know if that, like, I don't know, I'll have to ask sometime if that was, like, how much that was to get that done that way. I'm a musician myself, I might want that done for myself. Anyway, getting into the set, we learned a lot from our last experience not to underestimate these indie bands, boy howdy. But wow, right out the gate, it's incredibly high energy, and that is a understatement. Incredible understatement. High energy is an understatement. These shows, Blank State shows, are holy shit energy. Like, they're ludicrous speed.
Ludicrous speed!
Okay, maybe not ludicrous speed, but like, it was fucking dope, okay? And, you know, sure, maybe our shots were a little hard to get for all the moving around, but these guys were having a great time, and you could tell that the entire set. It was awesome. And we're here for that. We are here for that kind of behavior. So our shots be damned. The pictures came out cool anyway. So Get Moving the Crowd does, right? And like, it's a bunch of dancing and jumping around to the music, and it's awesome. It is incredible energy all across the venue. Great job, Blank State. Again, just like it says in the post, you guys don't need us to tell you that. You don't need me to tell you that. You guys know exactly what you're doing up there. And if you don't, the point is that you fucking look like you do. You guys are rock stars. Party on, Wayne.
Party on, Garth.
That joke would work on many more levels if there were someone involved in any of this named Wayne. There is not. Next up, we've got Nervous Surface, and in the post we talk a little bit about how, like, they threw us off a little bit, not in a bad way. The takedown and the setup between Nervous Surface and Blank State was really quick. We go into a little bit about this. The show didn't really skip a beat between the two, though, and the reason for that is a lot of the members of Blank State perform with Nervous Surface. That was really cool. We weren't really expecting that. We also really weren't expecting four guitars on the stage in front of us, which was just awesome. So Nervous Surface gets up there and does their thing, right? And the energy is electric, it's amazing across the venue. And there are two songs that I've mentioned in this post that I've got to talk about for a second. And the first is Lemon Lime, because that's one of my favorites. Both of these are my favorites out of their Nervous Surface's entire discography. But Lemon Lime, it's got this intro to it, you've got to listen to it. It's you can't help but sing along. Or, I'm sorry, scream along after you've heard it a couple of times. The second one is Dragon Sounds, which is just, like, I just love this jam. Like, I love both of these jams so much, but, like, Dragon Sounds is one of those songs that's, like, you know it when you hear it, you know? Both of these have that kind of signature to them. One has that classic, like, almost call to action sort of shouting in the beginning. You know, you gotta stop letting yourself get so upset. And then, you know, the crowd jumps along with that next part. When you're expecting, you know. And then with Dragon Sounds, like, I have a difficult time describing the signature sound with Dragon Sounds. It's just got one. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, amazing, amazing set. Nervous Surface, awesome job. Incredible work. So what's the news between Blank State and Nervous Surface? Well, the news is that it's kind of similar news between both bands. They're going on tour. Nervous Surface heading as far up as New York, and Blank State heading to also to New York in Brooklyn. Blank State will be going for much of May here, it looks like the end of May, from 5:15 to 5:26. We won't see them back home until May 25th in Raleigh if you want to catch them on in the Triangle. Or if you want to catch them in South Carolina, if you're feeling like a good little drive. Greenville is where you'll see them. After that, we'll start probably, hopefully, seeing some regular local shows from them again. Nervous Surface heading all the way up to New York, and we won't see them back until they play, what is this, Amos's South End. I'm probably not saying that right. I've not been to Charlotte a lot of times. But we won't see them back until May 8th, roughly, back in North Carolina. So best of luck. Hope they have a good time, both bands. You guys do awesome out there. We know you're going to. Yeah, just have a good time. Let's get into our last performance of the Den show, right? Let's talk about the Iliad. Wow. This set was something else. I know, as I'm looking at the post right now, I know that's the first sentence. That's the first little bit in it. But, like, there's not a more apt wording that I could use to start this off. Like, the Iliad did have this, like, sense of nervousness that starts, but I'm taking that as, like, I'm taking that to be, like, preset jitters, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just rolled off after getting the vibe from the crowd. And that, watching that happen from an audience perspective, like, for me, it's one of my favorite parts about going to local shows, is watching when that local level artist just steps in to their home on stage, you know, or in the round, or wherever they happen to be doing their music. It's incredible. But yeah, after we get this vibe, the post goes on to talk about that we get a series of vibes that, from the look of it, so many legendary artists' influences are in there, you know? Like, some parts we're watching the Iliad, Pure and True, it says. This is where we're getting that, like, missed series of series of disastrous events that the Iliad talks about in their Spotify bio, that's what an Iliad is. The Iliad is a, this is a direct quote from the Spotify, the Iliad is a musical experience of living through misfortune and coming out of it alive and better. And I think that this is the vibe that the Iliad puts off in this part of the show all around. When I say Pure and True, this is them. And then there were other parts of the show that feels vaguely like we're watching Prince or Frank Ocean, or even, like, there were some shots that I got that I didn't quite get to really mess with as I liked. They were a little too blurry and I couldn't keep them. But there were some shots that looked almost a little like Hendrix-y, some looked like a Little Richard kind of sort of. It was so cool watching this, like, and again, Tony with the lighting, GOAT status, but that was a big part that played into these shots I was getting. Like, you can see on the post, some of these are just incredible. So I had to style it a little differently. It was, the shots were too pristine, man. just the angles I was able to get with this artist. But yeah, both the set, the vibes, everything, it was all amazing. And it is a special artist that can transform a set into a journey. Let alone can a series of artists do this to a whole show. You know what I'm saying? Like, just talking about the show bill in general, the entire night was a vibe. Like, if I crafted that playlist on Spotify, it would definitely be in, like, I'm gonna stay in, I'm gonna chill, I'm gonna hang out with my dog, you know, get cozy, maybe read a book. You know, it's just a vibey, it would be a vibey playlist. And that journey I'm talking about over the course of the evening, like, these artists did an amazing job of transporting us from Ogburn Ave to wherever they wanted to mentally put us as a crowd. Incredible work to the Iliad, incredible work, Blank State, Nervous Surface, Folk Knot, The Den, all of it. Fantastic. Awful segue, but you know what else is fantastic? Boba. I could go for some boba. I could also go for some donuts. where can I get donuts and boba at the same time with a reliable schedule that I know they're going to be open when I get there, and it's relatively close by? They're not paying me to say anything, guys. You guys know how this works. I promote all of you guys at the local level. Small businesses, content creators, musicians, artists, all around the board. So I found this place. If you want to get donuts and boba tea, it's called In Town Donuts and Boba. It's at 167 Jonestown Road in Winston-Salem. They're open from 7 to 7, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Only exception is Sunday, where they're open from 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. So that's In Town Donuts and Boba. And full disclosure here, guys, I'm just on Yelp right now. Let's go through these guys' like first three reviews together and see what we see. First one is 5 stars, submitted February 13th of this year from Fred B. in Winston-Salem. It says, "This small shop is near the far right edge of Summit Station Shopping Center off Jonestown Road. There is a location in Kernersville as well. It offers a large assortment of sweet treats, donuts of all sorts, cream horns, bear claws, long johns, pine cones, cinnamon rolls, and their incredible tasting, very large apple fritter. They also offer a variety of hot and cold drinks, tea, coffee, lattes, and even smoothies. I've tried much of the available items, including long johns, bear claws, a handful of differently glazed donuts, and cream horns, but my absolute favorite is their apple fritter. I've not tasted better. I also love that you can have the long johns and cream horns filled with your choice of custard, vanilla, lemon, or raspberry. I've tried them all. They are great. And the small handful of free donut holes is charming. Ambiance, 4 out of 5. Food, 5 out of 5. Service, 5 out of 5. Value, 5 out of 5. Great review from Fred B. On to the second one, Brendan N. from Winston-Salem. August 6, 2023. I love In-Town Donuts. This may sound blasphemous in Winston-Salem, but I prefer them over Krispy Kreme. Oh, the scandal. They have a great selection from your conventional donuts to apple fritters, long johns, multiple fillings you can choose from. My favorite is the custard, bear claws, butterflies, and giant cinnamon rolls. They never disappoint. The service is always fast and friendly, and I love that they give you a couple of donut holes free as a treat. Break away from Krispy Kreme and give this much smaller local business a try. 5-star review from Brendan in Winston-Salem. Awesome. Next in line, Hannah F., Winston-Salem, August 6, 2023, 5 stars. One of my favorite spots for donuts in Winston-Salem. The donuts are always fresh and the service is quick. Today I got my favorite donuts, the strawberry butterfly, which is a donut with strawberry jam in between the donut layers, and the bear claw, which is a donut with an apple cinnamon filling. There are plenty of options for everyone, and if donuts aren't your thing, give their boba tea a try. My favorite thing the staff does is sneak a few free donut holes in with your order. Always a welcome surprise every time. So people are raving about these donut holes. That's another 5-star review from Hannah F. This place is apparently real popular with people for a variety of treats, and I'm looking over the reviews for the whole page right now, and like, this is just their regular Yelp page, and the lowest one I'm seeing, this is like 7 pages long, the lowest one I'm seeing on the first page is a 4-star in 2022, and even then, like, I'm pretty sure it's just because he doesn't want to give them 5 stars. Like, there's nothing innately bad about the interview or anything. So, yeah, 5-star donut place. Local small business. Check them out. Once again, that is In Town Donuts, 167 Jonestown Road, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. If it is between the hours of 7 and 7, Monday to Saturday, and on Sunday, you'll catch them open 7 to 2. Let's get into your next music block. It's Cypher 99, the 99.9 central playlist for local rap and hip-hop. As usual, if I'm pronouncing any of these incorrectly, could you guys just, like, politely let me know in a comment section or something, and I can issue corrections on our Instagram or in the next episode or whatever have you. Anyway, up first is G Santana, LL Cool K, Forever Jabron, and Antion Scales with Villains. I like this track, And I like this track for reasons that I like a lot of these tracks, is that they're influenced so much by the world of hip-hop that these artists have been exposed to, and at the same time, they're producing hip-hop that modern hip-hop wishes it could be. You know what I'm saying? Like, the more famous you get, the more bound you are in your contracts and shit, and in what the FCC wants you to do, and what your label approves and shit like that. But at the local level, you know, at our level, that kind of goes away, and you kind of have this freedom. And it's weird that this is the level that record labels fall in love with you, right? And then they never get to see you this way again because they turn you into something else. I don't know, I'm fucking rambling, but I like this track as well as all of the tracks on this list for that reason, is that, like, that freedom. And these artists, like, it's not like these are the four biggest artists in the game. I couldn't tell you who is and who isn't. And I honestly don't think that's something that, as a community, local hip-hop should give a fuck about. But I'm rambling anyway. Fuck it. Anyway, yeah, first up we got G Santana, LL Cool K, Forever Jabron, Anteon Scales. We got Villains. Second, we got Puff Don't Pass by King Osi, Rumi the Beast, and G Santana. G Santana's got a lot of features through this hip-hop community, I'm gathering. Like, I see his name across a lot of these guys' lists and stuff. Like, it's kind of connected, like, its own little community. It's really cool. Anyway, third up is Juice Lord, Kick in the Door. Fourth, we got Austin Royale, Move. Again, just keep in mind what I said. Like, these guys, they all, like, kind of put out these different kinds of hip-hop, and it's super cool. Like, it's almost like they all come from different eras of the genre, you know what I'm saying? Keep an ear out for that while you listen to them. I'll let them get to doing their thing. I'll catch you guys on the other side of it. Later on.
99.9. Hey, bitch.
Too tired, red seats in my eyes. I just been killing shit, I've been on playing shit. They tell me play this shit, she get the dancing like she never met me. That look in her eyes, say that she ready. I know my ancestors really proud of me. I'm talking black fists in a casket, I might dig them up just to dap them up. What a Tupac, never hit them up. What a J, never made a song cry. I'd probably still be a Burger King trying to upsell niggas large fries. I guess it was destiny, that's why she's texting me. Don't do no flexing, I keep my receipts like a cheap nigga or a cheap bitch. They got a jet, she gon' take back. We Indian givers, I'm dick slanging. No sporting goods like Django Lane, bitch, say my name.
I done got upset, I'm in the club with the roughneck, crunk ass, drunk ass, thug ass, kinda dysfunctional. Never get over emotional, got too drunk now, I'm seeing multiple.
Damn,
I gotta run up a check. Bitch ass nigga, what you think I'm supposed to do? Prison my mouth all black, yeah, I look unapproachable. Really, I'm social. I'm the villain, I look like the Joker do. Harley Quinn by my side, is you ready to ride? Every time that I drop, my temperature rise. I'm going up, away. Benjamin Franklin's tucked away. I know your mammy, your granny, they both understand me. They meet me in front of the bank.
Who the cleanest in the land? Got more raps than Christmas Day. Treat a pussy nigga like a stray. Be a brat like Wade and James. I call Scales Carmelo. He be scoring from hella range. I be running it up, you should try to catch the pace. Little nigga, you can catch a fade. Buckshot bullets to the face. Y'all be tempting me to rage. Talking two fists to the face. But I let you laugh and play. Just know the green light set the fit. We talking capital, nothing to cap upon. Run it up like a relay race. When we start up some business, gotta stay loyal to the day. Shooter, keep that thing tough. And he waiting for the save. I'm creating like I'm Tyler. Chopping meats in the kitchen. Then we mix it like a stew. Put ingredients in it. I was a little homie first, then the nigga stepped up.
Facts.
Had to put my niggas on.
Facts.
Had to make it possible.
For real.
Never an obstacle, never impossible. Gotta have everybody straight. I'm just too focused, gotta be rolling.
What's
and this
up?
Is the motion you cannot fade.
I'm on top of the world. You know we fucking your girl.
Yeah.
You love I'm dogging her out.
Yeah.
They be using my name for clout. We the last real niggas in a drought. I need all my paper, can't call the amount.
Nah.
I need all my paper, can't call the amount. I'm on top of the world. You know we fucking your girl.
Yeah.
You love I'm dogging her out.
Yeah.
They be using my name for clout.
it up, puck, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that stick keep crash. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that stick keep crash. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. Nigga, this that rapper weak. Bust it out the rapper. Bet I'm puffin' on some chronic treat. Give me a BG water and a half a zip of purple, please. Somewhere down in Florida on the beach, chillin' comfortably. Listen, bro, don't fuck with me. Nigga, don't you blow my high. I'ma have to blow my nine. Take your girl and blow her mind. Should have never paid no mind. She go low and lick me up. Lay her down and kick her out. This that Carolina flow. Gate City, what I'm talking about. Wanna get the race and smoke it out. Wanna get some land and grow it out. Had a QP at my mama house. 18 with a shotgun in the couch. My dudes almost had to kick me out. All my niggas known for airing out. That's why smoke to calm me down. You just gon' load my weed on loud. I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that stick keep crash. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that stick keep crash. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puck, don't pass. Roll it up, puck, don't pass.
Young nigga, chase that bag. Blue face, Ben Frank, make a nigga 100-yard dash. Yeah, I gotta get that cash. When I come touchdown, like a fucking 100-yard pass. I don't even smoke like that. Lil' bitty, quit lying. Quit cheapin', got a blunt back. She gon' spread, get ahead like a damn doobie rap. Niggas in that they so busy talking about the trap. Whoa, niggas gon' hate on my clique. My chick, when she leave, she come back with the stick. Leave you fallin' like Autumn, I'm ballin' like Spalding. The Mac get the ringin' like, boy, you callin'. Motherfucker, damn, 9 to 5. I was high at 5 and I quit it at 9. I ain't chasing no dreams if this shit is not mine. All business that don't pay for my time. Time is money. Make sure it's in your interest how you invest. I'm blowing this loud. It calm a nigga down whenever I'm stressed. Blowing this gas. Puffing, I puff, nigga, no, I don't pass. And if I do better, watch out where you ask. You know it's the sticky, that grass.
I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that sticky grass. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that sticky grass. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. Roll it up, puff, don't pass.
Roll it up, puff, don't pass. Santana be puffin' that gas. In the stew with a zip in the bag. Back in work, then I zig, then I zag. In and out of traffic, making these plays. No, I'm not acting, I don't be in plays. Every new day, there's no money to crave. You not on my level, then back from my face. Who this young killer looking like a hill figure? Rockin' Tommy, no hill figure. I'm all about my figures. I'm all about my cheddar at the same time, mozzarella. I'm sick of these haters, they talk out they neck and they talkin' so slick. I rock a fella if you talkin' legit. Me and my team, we all about checks. I'm laying these layers, and I'm stacking these Pringles. And at the same time, I'm all about my singles. And when I talk to shorty, she like when we mingle. And she heard the new song, and she say,
I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that sticky grass. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I got my foot on the gas. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. I take your girl and I smash. She drop a stick and she crash. Nigga, that sticky grass. Knowing this pack won't last. Roll it up, puff, don't pass. Roll it up, puff, don't pass.
I just wanna dedicate this to anybody going through a hard time. Anybody feel alone? We can get through anything together. I'll kick in the door for you now.
Just for my niggas to meditate. Just tryna make it by day to day. They got us living in Section A. Living a lie that we can't escape. You wanna burn niggas at the stake. Think you see four of us detonate. Don't give a fuck about head of state. Cause I'm tryna give us some better days. Bitch, I love all of my niggas. Cause all of my niggas is niggas that's never gon' quit. You niggas focus on money, but my niggas hungry. We focus on eating the rich. Bitch, it go down in the pit. I'ma get lit. Wait till I finish this fifth. I got the drop for the drift. How we gon' vent? These rappers ain't talking about shit.
police. Another black man dead in the streets. Masked up trying to hide from disease. No day job, nigga, how we gon' eat? No chill, but he make all my beats. Stick to my morals, I live what I preach. Game it for me, I gotta cheat. Won't make it to prison, so fuck the police.
Bitch, I'm a villain, your heroes is focused on killing and taking my life. If I gotta perish to save all my people, then fuck it, I'm ready to die. I'ma keep giving till I ain't got nothing for me, bitch, I'm losing my mind. And if I go crazy, just tell my little baby his daddy the truth in his prime.
Hard work, much stress. I got a kick in the door. Can't sleep, not yet. I got a kick in the door. Before I rest, I got a kick in the door.
I beat
my chest. Bitch, I'm a kick in the door. Bitch, I'm a kick in the door. I got a kick in the door. Bitch, I'm a kick in the door. I got a kick in the door. Bitch, I'm a kick in the door. I got a kick in the door. Bitch, I'm a kick in the door. I got a kick in the bitch. I'm a kick in the door.
Coming up, there was criticisms, hidden as suggestions. Fake supporters, that was really just finessing. Claiming love was the essence of their intentions. No, nigga, you faker than the fucking shoes niggas got from barbershops and water school. Boy, I see right through you, you and your bitch too. Man, you know the rules, she gon' motherfucking choose if she want to. It's levels to everything, boy, I mean everything. The hoes rich and shit, you gotta know on how to spend it. Never heard of misses, all the hoes I'm hitting either won't be with me or just want the dick and say I ain't dependent. They say I never listen, girl, I only listen when I'm missing. You ain't talking chess and you ain't talking business. You not fucking with beginners. There since I was 15, had the same team that will mislead, only chase cream. Niggas know when we drop the cold, they ain't think it's naughty knows how to flow. Shout out Bronto, had the hoes wanting clothes. He ain't even know we was on a roll.
I'm pissed off about everything in general, and so all these songs are pretty much about my battle with things that piss me off. I just want to beat the shit out of it. It's like a real threat to people. We've offended too many people. Everyone wants to see us die. I might just keep going just despite those fuckheads, you know?
Man, what the fuck you know about being true to you and nobody fucking with you? When you fighting off depression, they tell you express it, but they never seem to get the message. Mama worried about me, had to see the reverend, cause she says the demons that I'm dealing with. Your baby boy, he ain't innocent since he left home, he been in some shit.
What? Another awesome music block from the 99? Guys, I think I'm getting good at this. So, this is normally the part of the show where we would bring in our radio serial. But as an episode has not yet been recorded, I cannot present you guys with an episode. So, what I'll do instead is just kind of give you guys a little status update. Ashes of Avernus, you know, organizing people is hard. It's tough. So, you know, right now we're trying to figure out dates that work for all of us to get our serious recording bits done. And, you know, kind of get everybody settled into their characters and accustomed to what systems we'll be using. All that Jimmy Jazz. So that's kind of the update with Ashes of Avernus, but when it's done, it's going to be a really, really cool radio serial. Just stick around for that. as I can develop a proper summary for Ashes of Avernus, I'll give you guys one. But as of right now, it's really hard to summarize that story at this time. However, there is something neat that is on the block to be teased. So, a while back on our Instagram, once again, that's at 999theZ, we're approaching damn near an hour into the show now. I feel like if you're, like, chiming in at an hour, maybe I don't have to say that again. I don't know, maybe I do. But it's at 999theZ. There's an older Instagram post in there, possibly a couple of them, that mention a Patreon. And, like, us trying to figure out, like, how we're gonna best provide in that Patreon. Like, how we're best gonna generate content for you guys. So, might have figured out a way. we're kind of we're collaborating with our partners with the Level series just a little bit, the guys that write our radio serials for us. We're partnering with them, and we may be creating like a group Patreon thing. No real details just yet. We're teasing around a few things. We're throwing shit at a wall and seeing what sticks, basically. But it's coming. It's coming. I don't know when. I don't know what it's going to offer. I don't know what kind of content it's going to be there. But it's coming. It's going to be a collaboration between the 99 and the Level series and all of our partners kind of in those brands. So what I do have for you, though, is an update, like, for, like, a really cool update that is, I don't know, it's got some oomph to it, is the Smeft update. I think you guys will be pretty excited? Question mark? I don't know, we'll see. But, so we have an alpha preview for you guys.
What?
Oh, yeah. So, since we have all the characters that we want, but we just don't have, like, the custom stages or any of the extra shit we want to throw in there, we're like, you know, we can give you guys a taste of what you're in for. Also, just a heads up, the tier system hasn't been implemented yet. We are putting in a tier system that is going to more accurately reflect these characters in their matches to their canonical power levels. Now, in some cases, you're thinking, that's not as fun because, like, there's no way that a D tier character could win. You'd be surprised. with what we've picked out, you'd be surprised sometimes. Now, a lot of the time, you're not going to be very surprised, and it's just kind of going to be like it. Like, if there's like an S tier character against like F tier, it's just going to be like face smashies all day. But sometimes it's pretty good, you know. There's balancing methods that we're working in there, I guess, is what I'm leading up to. But anyway.
Fight!
destruction, but the reaper's still watching. I'm losing my grip, and I keep falling short. I'm deaf to the truth. Overcome the pain. Bury the misery. It'll drive you insane. What is it? Overcome. Drag me down. Bury me now. What is it? Overcome.
That was the Smeft Alpha preview. Again, I can't stress enough, it's Alpha. But yeah, so that Luffy and Homelander fight, huh? Like, nah, dude. No way Luffy would get swept like that. Like, I'm eager to start implementing the tier system as soon as possible, but there's still so many edits that have to come in and be done before, you know, before we get to that step. Fight 2, Saitama and Omni-Man, just... That was another one. I don't know what the turning into Zack Snyder's Superman was about. I might have to find a different model for that Omni Man, because he does, as far as I'm aware, he doesn't have frost breath. Y'all correct me if I'm wrong. I haven't read very far ahead in the comics, but I'm up to season 2 in the show. That reminds me, I've still got to watch that finale this evening. I've heard it's good. And then that third fight, you know, what an ending. What an ending. Goku versus Superman. And wow, like, I was almost satisfied with that one. But, you know, once again, none of the tier system has been implemented or anything like that. Those two would be pretty even. This whole simulation was designed for all three of these fights to be fairly even, but only one of them actually was. Yeah, that's crazy. And just to clarify with everybody, the way that Mugen works, or like the way that I do it when running these previews, and like what the way we're gonna do it running the show, is we just kind of put it on the watch function and just turn it loose. We just set it up in the tournament bracket, so there's no involvement or player input from us whatsoever. And just to kind of go over a little bit of the distance between Alpha and Beta here, is that, we need to implement the tier system, and we'd like to get all of the characters taken care of before we move on to things like stages and, like, music and all of that whatnots, you know, and all of the extra things that we want to throw in as features with the program. So, you know, a little bit of a distance left to go, but the process moves along pretty quickly, so we should get there pretty soon. Let's get into this last music block. Wrapping us up today is the Future Core genre, our newest playlist on our list of awesome playlists for you guys. Future Core, it's a little... The description on it is a little misleading. It just says electronic and synth music. And initially, sure, that's what it was designed to be, but there are other instrumentals that kind of, like, cross that boundary in between that I've found, and like a few other tracks as well, ones with vocals. Most of them just get slid into the vibes, you know, for like indie sounds, but with Future Core we're trying to bring that out a little bit more. So first up in this music block is Haunted with Lighthouse, and you definitely do get that vibe of like being on that top railing, like on that top platform for a lighthouse, and just looking out over the ocean. You do really get that vibe with this song. I also get like standing on a skyscraper, like middle of the night, standing on a skyscraper that has this like serene view of the city. So that's Haunted, H-U-N-T, 3D, with his song Lighthouse. Second in the block is Space Heater with Cobb Salad. This track is funky. I mean, just like it's got the funk, you know? Like, it starts out with this really weird sound. You'll see what I'm talking about. But then the rest of it, like, I get this real swanky vibe to it, you know? Like, I'm in a jazz club, but maybe that's from the trumpet in the background or whatever horn that is. I get that vibe of being like in a swanky jazz club. There's like this red chair and I'm sitting in it, and I got this pipe that's way too big for my face, and I've got this big ass coat on, you know? Like, I don't know, man. It's jazzy, it's funky, I like it. Cobb Salad by Space Heater. Third in the block, we've got Terrestrial Animal and Scott Shaw with their song Samsara, the Symphonic Odyssey remix. This song is an adventure, just straight up an adventure. This will mentally take you places if you let it. I get these very historic scenes, like these epic historic scenes, and I can't quite place the time period through the song. Some of it's Nordic, some of it's like Roman, others of it I'm in like a desert. Yeah, it's super cool. It's a longer track, clocking in at just a hair over 8 minutes, but epic work, Terrestrial Animal, Scott Shaw. You guys killed it with this one. Samsara.
Dear God, it's beautiful.
And last but not least, taking us out of the show with a fantastic finish, it is DJ Critfail, The Howling. This track, I get the vibe at the start of the track of being in this like mystical forest, and then there's this opening in it where it's really peaceful, and then the song picks up into this really intense vibe, and it's like something followed me home or something, like through the forest. It's a really interesting scene. All of these scenes can speak differently for all of you. That's gonna do it for us here at the show. Thank you guys so much for, you know, hanging out and signing on, being a part of this with us. We'll see you guys next time. The new schedule has us coming out every 2 weeks, so it won't be next Thursday, it'll be the following. Yeah, we'll see you guys then. It's the 99 Future Core.
99. Thank you. Thank you.